Hello, this is Dr. Jillian Camwell. I teach oboe at Troy University, and this is the Alabama 2022 Middle School Lyrical Etude. So you just saw me play with some dolphins, and the reason why I chose those dolphins was because this piece reminds me of a dance and dancing gracefully, and I couldn't think of a more graceful animal than the dolphin. So who wouldn't want to play along with some dolphins in the ocean? So thought that would be a little fun touch to play for you guys. The first thing that I would recommend doing if you're just starting to learn this piece is to clap and count the rhythms throughout. So the predominant rhythm that we have through this piece is that dotted quarter note followed by 3/8 notes. So really make sure that you're comfortable with the dotted rhythm, that you don't rush off of that. So if we're counting 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you're going to clap 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1, 2, 3. So go through the whole piece. Sometimes that rhythm shifts to beat 2, like in measure 9. 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2. So just make sure that you are subdividing that dotted quarter note so that you are counting it accurately, and especially that you're not rushing off of that rhythm. The next thing to look at, we have a couple of ornaments. In this case, they are grace notes. They come at the end of the first section before the repeat sign, which we're not taking for this audition. So that's in measure 8, the EDC, and it comes in the very last measure, measure 24 of the piece as well, with the AGF. And you're just going to go ahead and play those on the beat. So it's going to sound like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So just think about placing those on beat 1 and just playing a quick EDC, and it's better to play them slowly and controlled rather than too quick and not accurately. So just make sure that you're playing them accurately and you've got all the time in the world. You could play da 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 da, and that would sound lovely, and a judge would not hold that against you if you played it a little bit slower. The next thing I would do is to go through and mark all of your F fingerings. Now, I've gone ahead and looked through the entire etude before I played it, and I recognize that I only ever need to play my regular F. So if you don't know what I'm talking about when I say regular F, I'm going to put a fingering up on the screen here for you, but it is basically fingerings 1, 2, 3 in the left hand, so your B, A, and your G, and then 1, 2 in the right hand, and the little silver key that you're playing with your ring finger right below the E key kind of looks like a soup bowl. I had one student call that the soup bowl key, so that's what I'm going to call it. Sometimes they call it the banana key, but it does look a little bit like a soup bowl, so we'll go with that. Most of you might have learned one fingering called a forked F, and that would be 1, 2, 3, 1, and then open, and then finger 3 on the bottom. And sometimes that fingering is used with your E flat key. If you're using exclusively forked F, I would really encourage you to go through slowly and try playing it with the regular F fingerings. We only really want to use forked F if we are approaching the note or the F fingering or the F note, approaching it or going to a note that requires that ring finger on the right hand. So if I'm going to a D, or I'm coming from a D, or I'm going to an E flat or a D flat, and those are of course C sharp or for D sharp. So in this piece, we actually never approach the F from one of those notes. So we can just use the regular F. It's very easy to get to, and it has a much clearer tone. It's usually way better in tune than the forked F, and it's nice and clear. So it's nice and comfortable to play. If you have five keys on your left hand, where your left hand pinky will play, then you actually have a third F fingering called left F. And that would be used in place of forked F. But again, because we don't need to use forked F in this etude at all, then you also don't have to worry about your left F fingering. So again, for all of the Fs in this piece, I would use regular F. The next thing to think about are the dynamics throughout this piece. For the most part, we have a two-bar phrase with a crescendo and a diminuendo, and then sometimes there is an accent or something unusual. And if we don't play da 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 da, measure four, there's an accent on this second beat. So that's a little unusual. So anything that comes away from our 1, 2, 3, our dance-like pattern where we have a little bit stronger beat on beat one, something that comes takes away from that, we want to bring out a little bit more. So that accent on measure four, make sure you sing that out nice and clearly, a little bit louder. When we play accents on the oboe, we want to open our embouchure, be nice and relaxed. We don't want to force air and suddenly just play really loudly on that note. It'll sound a little bit too tense, a little bit too harsh of a sound. We want to get what's achieve this bell tone sound. So a bong, a little bit louder, but then we still want the note to ring afterwards. Da 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 bong. So think about those accents as a bell tone. We also have a couple of measures where instead of starting softly and crescendo, we start a little bit louder. So if you see in the second section, the third line down, that would be measure 9, 10, 11, 12, measure 13 and 14. They start with diminuendos. So you can start a little bit louder at the beginning of those measures so that you have somewhere to come back from. Da 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 da. And then even if you don't have a diminuendo or a crescendo in a measure, there's usually something you can do that is musically interesting to hold our attention and show that there's always direction in a phrase. There's never a note that stays stagnant. It's always going somewhere or coming from somewhere. So you can really show that in your playing and make you stand out in the audition process. The last thing I want to draw your attention to is breathing. This is a slower tempo at quarter note equals 84. So it's really important that you learn how to exhale and to inhale before you start playing. You want to really tank up. So think about tanking up your gas here. So we want to have a nice exhalation to make room for fresh air, get rid of your stale air, and you'll be able to play for longer. So this is a tough one because even though we're not playing with the repeats, it is a slower tempo and we have to have good control of our air support. So I would encourage you to work on that, mark in where you're going to breathe. Sometimes you might just breathe out. For example, measure 10, where there's a rest, and then there's a rest two bars later. You might not need to breathe in both places. So you might choose to just exhale in measure 10, and then just inhale in measure 12. So that would be da 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 da. And then breathe in that second quarter rest. Well, I hope this was helpful for you today, and I am looking forward to any comments or feedback or questions that you might have about playing this lyrical etude for Alabama's 2022 All-State Audition. Good luck!